Hello, now I'm going to show you how to create masters on the payroll. So we put the company login. And the ID. So we'll look at masters. So we go to department. So we add, so I'll give the name, so I'll have accounts department, save and continue. I'll have HR department. I'll have production department. So you can limit the number of employees in a department by putting the maximum numbers. Then we save. So that is how we create department. Then we go to, so if you have a sub department, maybe under accounts, maybe we could be having purchasing, could be having finance, so you can add the sub departments. So we look at designation. So here you can also, you can add or you can also import. So I'll put, we have accountant, we have HR, we have maybe general worker, so we have created. Then we have category. We add, so category will be, you can classify your employees as experts and non-experts, or you could be having union staff and non-union staff, you could be having management and non-management. So I'll create mine, management. Non-management. Then we have wage rate for casuals. When we add, so here we put the wages. So maybe I have rate of 300 or 400 shillings, which is per day. $400 per day for 8 hours. Maybe I have another wage rate. For 500 shillings per day. So you can also create your rates per hour. So for 8 hours they get paid 500 shillings. Then we have salary grades. So you can add. So here you can put job group A. What is their salary? Maybe job group A, the salary is 100,000. If they're getting house allowance, you specify they have pension also, you specify. Then you save. So that is how we create job groups. Then we have loan setup. So we add. So here I will have bank loan. Then we specify the interest rate. What is the rate that is being given? Maybe it's 14%. And the interest is fully charged to the employee, so 100. Interest type, yearly or monthly. Is it on reducing balance? Then we save. So you can have as many as possible. You can also import. Then we have benefit group. So we have servants, services. So servants will have the cook, guards, and services will have water, electricity, telephone. Then we have agricultural rates, which are different from the others. Then we have others. So under others, you can have your own other benefits that you're giving to employees. Then we have benefit setup. So as per this list, we have what is prescribed by the Kenya Revenue Authority as benefits. So if you have another non-cash benefit that is not listed here, you can create. So to create, you just click on add and you give the code of the benefit, maybe 05B. Then you give the benefit name. Maybe meals. Then you group it. So this will fall under others. If it is a percentage, you specify. If it has a monthly rate, then you specify as well. So that is how we create benefits. Then we have PF scheme. PF is Provident Fund. So you could be having a Provident Fund from Britam or from CIC or from UAP Insurance. So you come here and you click on add. You create the various Provident Funds. So you could be having Britam. Be having CIC. So you can have as many as possible. So you'll specify these PF schemes on the employee. So an employee is having a PF but is from Britam. Another one is having from CIC. So the same we have with pension scheme. So you add, you'll have pension scheme from Alexander Forbes. So I'll just copy the same here. Then we save. So you can have as many as possible. Then we have reasons for leaving. We click on add. I'll give a code. and reasons for leaving name. So we have termination. Then gratuity calculation type, days. So if you're paying gratuity, you say gratuity is how many days do you pay? 15 days per year work, or 16 days, you specify. So reason for leaving, I've put termination. I'll have also resignation. Then you save. So you can have as many reasons as possible. Then we have master one, master two. So for example, on the employee, you want to classify employees further. You've already used department, you have used sub-department, you have used designation, you have used category and class. So if you have other classifications, you will add them under master one and master two. So you can open and add. You add. So you'll give the name of the master one code. Then you save. Similarly to master two, you can add. Then we have banks, bank setup. So you add. So I'll put here Barclays Bank. I'll put the code for Barclays 03. I'll add KCB, code is 01, and save and continue. So if there are many, you'll just import the file. You'll click import, you'll generate a template, and you'll import the file once you have updated the template. Then we have bank branch setup. You click on add, so you'll select the bank, so maybe Barclays. The branch maybe is Nakuru branch. Then you'll give the code for the Nakuru branch, maybe 009. You can also put the Swift code as well. Then you add another one. Harambee. Harambee Avenue. And you give the code. In the Swift code as well. So that is how we add branches for the banks. Then we look at earning deduction. So here is where we create the allowances that employees enjoy. So we'll go to earning setup. So by default we have OT1, OT2 and absent. So I'll add others. So for example, we have leave pay. So leave pay calculation type is a rate. It is taxable. NSSF and NHIF is calculated on it. Then we allow single entry so that someone cannot post twice. So maintain balance, that is if it is like a saving for the SACO shares. Then we click here on formula and create the formula for the rate. So for example, so it will be basic. So for example, for leave pay, maybe it is basic divided by 30. So that will be, so you'll put the number of days to be paid. Then we save. Another allowance that I can create is acting allowance. So this one will be variable. So we allow single entry. Then we save. So that is how we create earnings. So I'm going to show you how to create deductions. So by default we have salary advance. So we'll add a new one. So here we can have so many deductions. You can have your circle shares. Which could be fixed or variable. Then we save. You could also add union fee, for example, which could be fixed or variable. Then you save, so you can have as many deductions as possible. Next we look at earning deduction profile. So earning deduction profile is depending on the number of allowances and deductions you've created in the system. Some allowances will be applicable to only specific individuals, like maybe management staff would be getting certain allowances that are not applicable to other employees. So you can have as many profiles as possible. So by default we just have one default profile. So you can add another one and give it a name, then save. Next we look at earning deduction profile assignment. So the profile that we have created, default profile, so by default it will have all the deductions that you have created. So if you have two different profiles, you will remove, if certain allowances are not applicable to a certain profile, you can remove by clicking on delete. Then you save. So that is earning deduction profile assignment. Then we have cost center. So here you can create the cost centers. So this is mostly for NGOs, non-governmental organization. Salaries come from different grants. So you give the code, then you give the grant. UNDP. So those are the cost centers. Then we have cost center profile. We add. So we create a profile. Maybe for HODs. So we'll say HODs, their salaries from UNDP will be 70% and the remainder 30%. So the total percentage should be 100. Then you save. So this profile you'll assign to employees, then their salaries will be split as per the cost centers. So that is all under masters. So next we look at employee details. So I'm going to show you how to create an employee. So we click on add new. So I'll select employee, whether it's regular or casual. I'll select title. Then I will give the name. I'll give the middle name. Then I'll give the date of joining. So whatever we have as asterisks are mandatory fields that must be filled. So I'll give the location. I'll give the category. I'll give the department. I'll give the designation. You'll also put nationality, religion, mother tongue. So I can search. I'll put the religion. I'll put gender, date of birth. Then I'll put marital status, whether it's married or not. I'll give insurance relief if he has. So to give you tick here, you add a new item. You put the name of the insurance company. You give the PIN for that insurance company. You give the policy holder if it is their self. Then we have policy, is it health, education, or life cover? So you choose either. You give the age, maybe 30 years. You give the policy number, commencement date of the insurance, then maturity date. Maybe it's a 5 year. Then date of payment of the premium. So if you are paying end month or the first day of the month, then you give that. Monthly premium that is being paid, maybe it is 3,000. So premium paid till date, you can also give. Sum assured, maybe it's 1 million. Then you save. So that is how we put insurance relief. Then we have statutory details. So here you put the NSSF number, you put the NHIF number, you put the PIN, KRA PIN number. So if he's on contract, you tick that. Then NSF, NHIF will be ticked by default, charge. If he's a disabled employee, you tick here and you put the certificate number given by KRA and you give the validity date. Then we have residential status, he's a resident and a primary employee. Then you give house allowance, if this person is getting house allowance, if it is a fix or a percentage of the basic. if he's housed by the company, you give him quarters, or the company is paying for him rent, you put that under quarters. You tick here and you specify the amount being paid for rent. Then if he's on provident fund, you specify. If he's on pension, you also specify whether it is fixed or a percentage. If it is a percentage on basic, then you specify the percentage. So now you can see where pension scheme name comes about. So we specify. Then we have HOSP, if it is applicable for home ownership savings plan. If they have mortgage, you also specify owner occupier interest. Then payment mode, is it paid by cash, by bank, by check? You specify. Once you've specified all that, then we save. So once we save, we can go to that employee and add more information. So I can select this person. If I go on the sidebar here, we have contact email. So this will be used to send payslip to the employee. Select. So we put here the email address. Then we save. So that is how we add email address. Then we have bank details. So here also we add. We click on add. We'll specify the bank. We'll select the branch. We'll put the account number. We leave the account name as the name of the employee. Account type will be salary account. Then net share will be 100. So if the employee has two banks and he wants to split the salary, you can give him two banks and specify the first bank percentage. Then we have bank transfer template. So if we create a bank format for uploading to sell to the bank, you'll select the bank template here. Then we save. Next we add contact phone. We give the form for mobile number. You give them a number. Then you save. Then we have address. So address is where this person comes from. You can give his permanent address. Maybe he lives in Buruburu. Phase 1. Then you give the country. So province we don't have and city we don't have, so you'll need to create the new save. So you can add those information and save. Next I will show you how to add language. So we add. So which languages can this person speak in written and spoken? So he can read, he can speak. So if he's an expert, you specify the same. Then we have national identity. So here we put the passport or the ID number. So So select document type. Then you put the ID. Then I say then we have qualification. You can add. Maybe he's a bachelor's, he has a bachelor's degree from the University of Nairobi. You will put his registration number. Sorry, qualification is university is that. Qualification maybe is done. Is done finance option. Then you can put in which year he finished and say 2016. Which grade did he get? Grade A or grade B? Then you save. Next we put remuneration. So remuneration is the salary the employee is earning. So we put the salary here. And if there are any other payments that are fixed or allowances, you'll see and you can put here. Like for example, if he has shares, you can put the share amount. Maybe he's contributing 2,000 every month. Then we save. So any fixed payment and deduction is posted here. Then we have car benefit. If the employee has been given a company car, it will give the registration number, the make, the rating of the car, which type of it, is it a salon car? Is it hired by the company or it's owned by the company? So you specify. Then you give the value of the car and you specify as active. So 2% will be calculated as the benefit for the car. We have non-cash benefits. So this is where we specify mobile, telephone, cooks, guards, or furniture, provision for furniture. So you click on add new, you choose if it is services, maybe it's electricity, so you specify quantity one, then you put the bill, the electricity bill for the month that is being paid for by the company. Then we have service gratuity. So here the system will start accumulating gratuity. The gross, it will give the total pension plus NSSF as a yearly contribution. It will give you the tax relief, 1280 times 12. Then the tax paid for the year and how much is gratuity. So this will appear, gratuity will appear there. So that is all. Then we have history. So you'll be able to see if someone has joined, left, then rejoined again. So you'll be able to see all that information. So that is how we create employees. Then we look at separation. So if someone is leaving the company, you come and add, you select the person. Then you select the date. Then you choose the reason for leaving. Then you'll save. So that way the person will not be in the subsequent payrolls. So that is all on how to create masters on the payroll. In the next video, I will show you how to run the payroll. Thank you.